So like one time I got this DM from someone who said to me, "You don't know what you're talking about. The Bible is clear. Don't do drugs and like don't be gay and don't have sex." And then I just responded to them with two words. Prove it! Because if we can be really honest, the Bible doesn't offer a consistent sexual ethic or relational ethic. If you look at the Old Testament or the Hebrew Bible, like you'll actually see there's like technically 8 ways to have a biblical marriage. Does Abraham having sex with his wife's slave in order to have a child, like, is that biblical marriage? Is that cool? What about like Jacob, who like later became Israel, like working for Laban and being compensated with Laban's daughter, Rachel, as like his wages, like for working for him, like a human person, a woman being traded away like property? Is that biblical marriage? Is that cool with y'all? I mean, we can go on and on, but I think it's pretty safe to say that like we probably aren't basing our present like sexual or relational ethics on just the Bible. A lot of times sexual and relational ethics are shaped by culture. Protestants, we carry a lot of shame still. And I think we got a lot of it from like the Catholic Church. Like when we split, we kept that, kept the bad sex going. And then fast forward to our teen years when we all kissed dating goodbye and like got purity culture shame. And it just like became worse and worse and worse. And now fast forward one more time, I'll speak for myself. I'm creeping up in my 30s. I've been sexually active for about 3 years now, including being in a romantic relationship. Since having sex, I realized sex isn't bad. Like sex is actually really, really good for a multitude of reasons that I'll go into in other videos. But I'm still like very much coming from a place of like wanting to be able to justify myself biblically. You know, how is it that I know that it's okay to have sex outside of marriage? So I started studying and talking with people and like realizing that it's still possible to have a sex positive biblical sexual ethic that doesn't just jettison the Bible, because it's hard to wrestle with certain texts and like ways of things of knowing. And I kind of learned like the same framework that set me free in my queerness can also set me free in the area of sex positivity and sex being okay and good outside of marriage. So short answer, can Christians have sex before marriage and can it be holy and good? Yes. And you might be asking me, show me where in the Bible that someone is having sex before marriage and it was good. Turn with me, my friends, if you will, to the book of Genesis. What does it say there? I'm going to paraphrase it for you if you don't have a Bible nearby. Basically, in one of the creation stories, because there's two creation stories in Genesis 1 and 2, in the one that's more narrative, the second one, Adam, the first, the Adam, the human, the earthling, is charged with naming the animals, and he goes around and seeing that everyone had their pair. Everyone had their second person, someone who was about it, and he was all by himself, and God says it's not good for man to be alone. And God causes a man to fall into a deep sleep. While he was asleep, he took a rib, and from it he formed a woman. And then he woke up and said, "Bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh, you will be called Isha, for you were taken out of Ish," which is the Hebrew for, "You'll be called woman, for you're taken out of man." Did you hear at any point in that story the exchanging of like vows or some sort of marriage ceremony or the part where it says God pronounced them man and wife? No! They just like, they saw something in someone, like they both can, they had sex. Because like, that's just like, part of like their createdness, their sexuality, their sexual drive was part of their createdness. It wasn't like a product of their fallenness. It was because it's just like, oh my God, I see something in you that like I wanna share with and enjoy and delight in, and like I wanna give myself to you. But there was no wedding ceremony. So like, that's sex outside of marriage. So I hate to say it, but just like marriage is a human institution. Not necessarily one instituted by God, as we would have us to believe. Is marriage important? Yes. Is marriage like a sacred and beautiful thing? Yes. But it is also something man-made. Just because it's man-made doesn't mean that it's not sacred. I'm just pointing something out. It wasn't there in the beginning. Boop. So like, honestly, if we're taking the Genesis story literally, as many conservative folks do, then like sex before marriage, and that led to something good, like the entire human race. So now I'm gonna ask you to kindly turn to the book of Ruth, where if you want to, or I can just recap the story for you right quick. So it's a really, really sad story. Naomi has two sons. They're married to two Moabite women, I believe it was. One of them is Ruth, and both the sons die, and the mom, Naomi, says, "Hey, you guys should go back to the homes of your family because I can't take care of you." One of them leaves, but Ruth clings to her and says, Do not ask me to turn back from you, for where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and my God, your God will be my God. May I be dealt with, be it ever so severely, if anything but death separates you and me. That is a woman saying that to another woman. As far as I'm concerned, that is so gay. But also just like, it's just a beautiful picture of like being committed as family. And that's also what many evangelicals use in their own wedding ceremonies. Like I've heard it so many like Southern evangelical weddings. So I'm just saying it's pretty gay for a straight wedding. Anyways, it's another story for another time. They need help, they need a kinsman redeemer, which is Boaz. Mighty Boaz is on the scene, and Naomi says to Ruth, hey, you should go down to the threshing floor when he's drunk and passed out, and then lay with him in his bed, and he'll wake up after being drunk and think that he slept with you, and then by law, he has to marry you. All that transpires, and she goes and gets in his bed, and like uncovers his feet is the term, but basically just like she made sure he was naked. And she was in bed with him. Like, uncovering feet is euphemism for just being naked. She's naked in bed with him. He's not as drunk as she thought he was. And so he wakes up, not drunk, hey, like, hey, why are you naked in my bed? And then she's like, oh my God, you're my kinsman redeemer. Will you please help me and my family? And he's like, you know what? Because you are a good woman, stay with me. Like, yes, like, we're gonna like bring you into this family. I'll do this. But, and then it said just like, she stayed with him until the morning. And I'm just saying, there's a sun flare happening right there. I need to put these shades down, hold on. So Boaz wakes up and says, hey girl, why are you so like naked in my bed? And she's like, you're my kinsman redeemer. Can you please help me and my mother-in-law out? Otherwise we're fucked. She didn't say it in those terms, obviously. And so he's like, yeah, absolutely. So, and then it says, she stayed with him until the morning, which is a euphemism for what? Sex! There's weird consent things going on in the story, obviously, but you know, this is sex before marriage. Like, they didn't say they went down to the priest and he's like, hey, you guys can get married now, l'chaim. No, that's not how it happened. Here is another example of sex outside of marriage that it eventually led to something good, and that something good was like the birth of Jesus Christ. Ruth is Jesus's like great-great-great-great-grandmother or something like that. And that's just like two examples from the Bible. And there's plenty of other examples in the Bible of like women owning their sexuality and other things happening. So to sum it up, the Bible doesn't offer a consistent sexual or relational ethic. Actually, it contains examples of sex outside of marriage that can lead to really good things. And I'm not saying that the Bible says explicitly that you can have sex outside of marriage, but I am saying there's like precedent for it. So yeah, short answer, yes, you can have sex outside of marriage. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you like it, I've got new videos on Tuesdays and podcasts on Wednesdays and sex videos on Friday. That sounded weird, not sex videos, but videos about sex. And yeah, go ahead and subscribe, like, share, all those things, and comment below. Like, what did you hear about the Bible growing up? And like, what do you think about sex now? What questions might you have? I'd love to know so I can answer all that stuff. And if you think videos like this are important, you can become a sustaining partner on Patreon, which is a great way to support the creatives in your life, making the content that matters. So go to patreon.com/thekevingarcia, learn more, learn about the perks, meditation. We got a Slack channel, everything is good. Also, Queerly Beloved Tees presale goes on Monday. So make sure that you're signed up for the mailing list so you can get all the details on that. Links are below, all that shit. So I love you so much. And I will talk to you next time. Bye.